to keep all our peace. Sisters,
amen.
I thank God for your life. I thank God for what God is doing in our lives. You are all welcome in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Welcome our daddies, our mommies, and all the ministers of God. You are all welcome.
Amen.
We thank God for bringing us again to another beautiful day. Today is day 9
Hallelujah.
Of our season of soul strength. Our TSS.
Hallelujah.
December soul strength.
Yes, Lord.
December soul power.
Yes, Lord.
December soul prosperity.
Yes, Lord.
Who is with us on TSS?
I am on.
That's the word. I am on.
I am on.
I am not off.
I am not disconnected.
I am on.
I am on.
And I will finish well and strong.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
You should pray that for yourself, not amen for me. God bless you. The joy of the Lord is our strength.
Amen.
We will never frown. We will never go through any form of melancholy.
Amen.
Only joy will be our portion.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
God bless you. Please continue to share. Share the broadcast, share the prayer call. Call people to come and pray. Because when people begin to pray for themselves, that is when they get their personal strength.
Yes.
The Bible says, by faith, Sarah herself had to receive strength. She didn't depend on Abraham. She needed her own strength to be able to have faith to go through the process of being a mother.
Yes.
You need your personal strength.
Yes.
And you will not miss it.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
So how is your rest?
Amen.
And have you died today? The Lord God Almighty says every day is a day of death to the flesh. Die to the flesh. Because the flesh cannot inherit the kingdom of God. The flesh got to go. And the flesh will go.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
By the special grace of God, we are going to sing a song that will lead us to the soul meal today and for us to pray.
Amen.
The best way to pray is to pray the word of God.
Yes.
We pray scripture.
Yes.
That's how Jesus Christ prayed.
Yes.
He prayed the word. That is what works. Not the prayer points we copy from books that have gone into extinct. We pray God's word.
Amen.
And by the grace of God, we are going to receive the word today that will guide us to pray.
Amen.
So keep on sharing, keep on calling people. It is not conditional. It's not when you share that God will bless you. No. Those are lies.
Yes.
We're encouraging you to evangelize. We're encouraging you to encourage people to pray.
Amen.
That's why we're telling you to share.
Yes.
And by the grace of God, the Lord will gather such as should be saved.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus
Amen.
Christ. Some says we wait upon the Lord. That's what we are doing.
Amen.
We wait upon the Lord. When we are not people that are joking with our daddy God.
Amen.
And when people are waiting, they are called waiters.
Amen.
And sometimes look as if you are wasting time. But that is when you are working most. But it is not easy to wait. Because your mind, everything has to be subject to God.
Amen.
And what do waiters do? They serve. So where's your apron? April, though we are beep, I'll be complaining and crying. Or rather, waiters, though we are beep. Waiters, we are apron.
Yes.
They say, yes, what can I serve you? What you need? What you need? People are very beeps, they're complaining. What the little, you can only talk to me. I don't love me anymore. That is for babies. We are waiters. Are you a waiter?
Yeah,
I am a waiter. And I have my apron. In the spirit realm, doing my work for my Jesus.
In
the mighty name of Jesus Christ,
Amen.
We will wait upon the Lord.
Amen.
We will run and not grow weary. We will walk and will not faint. For the Lord will go before us, and His joy will be our strength. Mounting up with wings as eagles, as our spirits start to soar. When we come into His presence, and we wait upon the Lord, we will wait upon the Lord. For in His presence is fullness of joy. Mounting up with wings as eagles, as our spirits start to soar. When we come into Your presence, and we wait upon the Lord, we will wait upon the Lord.
Yes.
For in Your presence is fullness of joy. Joy and our strength Jesus Christ's mighty name we have prayed.
Amen.
Our daddy God, we come to you, Lord, just as we are.
Yes, Lord.
We bow before you because you are our Father,
yes, Lord.
Our Maker, our
yes,
Creator.
Lord.
Thank you, Lord God Almighty, for calling us.
Thank you, Lord.
For helping us thus far,
yes,
to wait,
Lord,
on you, Lord. Thank you because we trust you that,
yes,
faithfully has brought us this far.
Amen.
He will carry us indeed on eagle's wings.
Amen.
To the finishing line in,
amen,
the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
We raise an altar of the blood of Jesus Christ, the Lord.
Jesus,
we ask for your mercy, Lord God,
yes,
Almighty. Anyway, we have erred, we have sinned, the Lord, in thought, in word, in action, Lord. We ask for, Lord, for your mercy in the,
amen,
name of Jesus Christ. Repent, O Lord, of every known and unknown sin.
Yes,
Lord, let your mercy speak for us,
amen,
Lord. In the mighty name of Jesus,
amen,
Christ. Thank you for all your children over there that have gathered all over the globe, O Lord.
You, Lord.
On this global altar that are going to come, O Lord. Every one of them is important to you, Lord.
Amen.
Every one of them has a name, O Lord, and a destiny.
Amen.
I thank you for every one of them, Lord.
Amen.
I ask that, Lord, you will touch everyone at the very point of their need.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus,
amen,
Christ. Lord, touch your son, touch your daughter, touch,
yeah,
that family over there,
yeah,
touch that minister, Lord. Let there be renewal, let there be revival, refreshment on this global altar in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Thank you, sweet daddy, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Just lay your hands upon me, Lord.
Amen.
Sit upon me, wrap yourself around me, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Let no man see me, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Let only you be seen, my Father.
Amen.
Let your voice be heard by,
amen,
all in the mighty name of Jesus,
amen,
Christ. Thank you, our sweet dad.
Thank,
we love you forevermore. Take over the airwaves, take over the networks. Take over, Lord, the God Almighty, all the management, Lord.
Amen.
Nobody will block us in the name of Jesus,
amen,
Christ. You are unblockable.
Amen.
Therefore, Lord, we stand with,
amen,
you in the mighty name of Jesus,
amen,
Christ. Thank you, sweet dad.
Thank you.
Glory be to your holy name.
Yeah.
The rapture should take place while we are here, sweet daddy. Please. Take us and all of our family members,
amen,
to be with you at last.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus,
amen,
Christ. Thank you for answer prayer.
Thank you, God.
Glory be to your holy name. In Jesus Christ's mighty name we have prayed.
Amen.
Amen. And amen.
Amen.
Wow, what a wonderful day. We give God the praise. We give God the glory. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We want to start by giving us the announcement that by the grace of God, the DSS is on.
Amen.
We have our Zoom prayers on Tuesdays, on Thursdays, and on Saturdays, 11 p.m. Nigerian time. Please join us on the Zoom, on the Zoom prayers. It's called Soul Connection. In fact, to me, that's even the most important time, because we connect soul to soul. All of us are in his hand.
Yes.
He will give us 1 million. We'll handle us together.
Amen.
I encourage you to join us in the Zoom prayer.
Amen.
And then on Mondays, every Monday, 12 noon to 1, we have the soul hour.
Yes.
Those of us that we are here on Monday, the Lord really refreshed us,
yes,
renewed us,
yes,
strengthened us.
Amen.
People of God, you may be weak in the body, but your soul is strong.
Amen.
We're not walking by the body, we're walking by the soul.
Yes.
That is what matters.
Yes.
So we are here on Mondays, 12 noon to 1 Nigerian time, till the end of this month, if Jesus tarries. And then Wednesdays, Fridays, and Sundays, we are meeting for the soul meal.
Amen.
Wednesdays and Fridays, 4 p.m. Sunday is 6 p.m.
Amen.
It's bumper to bumper.
Hallelujah.
The Lord is training us,
amen,
in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Come on board. Come on board and let
yes,
the Lord God Almighty begin to see a son and a daughter that is strengthened in him.
Amen.
That will not fall by the wayside.
Amen.
That no wind of doctrine can toss them around.
Amen.
That they are stable in God.
Yes,
and God will achieve it.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Also want to announce to us by the grace of God that this Saturday we have baptism, water baptism. My immersion, and it is a biblical word, Acts 2:38 baptism.
Amen.
So if you're in Port Harcourt or around Port Harcourt, or even if you're abroad, you want to come, I'm sure you have the visa. Hallelujah.
Amen.
To come for the baptism is this Saturday.
Amen.
You can give us a call. You can call the numbers that are on the comment section. You can inbox me, and by the grace of God, the Lord will direct us,
amen,
on how to go about it in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
God bless you. I need to put this announcement so that it will be off the way,
Amen.
So that we can begin to flow
Hallelujah.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
God bless you.
Amen.
Put a smile on your face.
Amen.
The joy of the Lord is here.
Amen.
The Lord is here because he loves his children to have joy.
Amen.
Not happiness, but joy.
Yes.
A spiritual gift from God.
Amen.
And by the grace of God, God Almighty will give all of us
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
People of God, not everywhere is God's presence.
Yes.
Not every church program.
Mm-hmm.
Not every online ministration.
Mm-hmm.
Like I say, I'm in the presence of God. Sometimes God is not there.
Mm-hmm.
It is God's presence that we are looking for.
Yes.
And God's presence is determined by Him.
Yes.
He determines where He will go to.
Yes.
Look at 1 Kings chapter 19. 1 Kings 19, 11 to 13.
1 Kings chapter 19.
Yes.
I read from verse 11.
Yes.
And he said, go forth.
God is talking to Elijah. Yes.
And he said, go forth.
Said, go forth.
And stand upon the mount before the Lord.
Stand upon the mount before the Lord.
And behold, the Lord passed by.
The Bible says, take note. The Bible said, the Lord passed by.
And a great and strong wind rent the mountains.
People will think that it is God that caused it.
Yes.
Because as you say, you see big programs, you see so much noise, people are shouting, you say, ah, God must be there.
Yes.
The Bible says this mount is before the Lord. God is the one that gave instruction.
Mm-hmm.
He is the one that said you should go and stand there.
Yes.
Yet, when there was strong wind tearing the mountains,
mm-hmm.
all the noise, all the shouts of hallelujah, the hulabais,
mm-hmm.
the Bible says it break in pieces.
The mountains.
It break in pieces the rocks.
The rocks. Before the Lord.
Somebody said before the Lord.
Before the Lord
was there watching.
Yes.
Many times God is in churches, he's watching.
Mm.
He's not doing anything. He's not talking. He's just there watching.
Yes.
Looking at the drama going on. Looking at all the fake things that the pastors are doing. Most pastors are dealing with God's people with a book. God has reviewed that book. That book is titled 48 Laws of Power.
Mm.
Most pastors are using that book to teach people of God.
Mm.
And God Almighty is revealing them. He's exposing them.
Yeah.
That book tells people, tell the pastors, tell the leaders that the people must be loyal to them. They control people with that book. They say, if I don't bless you, you're not blessed. It is called 48. Go to the internet, you will see it. 48 laws of power. That is what these world powers are using. Most of the pastors, the GOs, the bishops, they are using that book. They're not teaching people the word of God. They are putting that book to manipulate and brainwash people. It is soul slavery. Idi Amin used it. Hitler used it. It is called 48 laws of power. If you go to the internet, you will see it. The laws are there. When you look at the laws, you begin to say it's operating in churches.
Yes.
This, that is why you see mountains tearing, one man of crowd, testimonies. People are stuck. They are going through issues. They are still masturbating. They are still committing fornication. They are still beating their wives. Yet, they are in a place where rocks are tearing.
But the Lord was not in
that thing. The Lord was not in that thing. He didn't do it. He didn't touch it. He was testing Elijah. To know that Elijah really knew his power. Go ahead.
And after the wind, an earthquake.
Earthquake began to come like the days of Paul and Silas that scattered the prison.
Yes.
God was there in Paul and Silas' case because they suffered because of the gospel.
Yes.
But in this case, God was not there.
Yes.
Read on.
But the Lord was not in the
Lord was not in earthquake. There are many earthquaking programs.
Yes.
Everybody is falling. The part of everybody will fall. It's looking as if everybody is vibrating. You call it anointing. Between the knees, as if you are feeling good. Shouting, kai, kai, kai. You think God is there. Earthquake is there. God said, I am not there.
And after the earthquake, a fire.
Fire. Holy Ghost.
Fire.
All manner of fire. God Almighty still said what?
But the Lord was not in
the fire. He was not in the fire. Where was he?
And after the fire, a still small
voice.
And
after all the noise of men, all their jumping, all their acrobatics, all their dancing, twisting their legs, cameraman is showing their expensive shoes and designer's wristwatch. After all that was done, what happened?
A still small voice.
A voice of peace. A voice of holiness, a voice of divine arrangement, a voice of where God is in charge. God is the one telling them, do like this, do like that. That is what came. And what happened? What was
and it was so when Elijah heard it.
When Elijah heard it, because it's a a man of God.
That's right. That he wrapped his face in his mantle.
He began to see that this is where God is.
That's right.
And my face cannot see this glory. And he did what?
And went out and stood in the entry.
Yes.
In of the cave.
Yes.
And behold, there came a voice unto him and said, what doest thou here?
You have to have fellowship with God to receive personal strength. Child of God, it is in times like this that God is calling us to quietness, stillness. Noise is everywhere. All manner of videos, all manner of riots, all manner of confusion. God is saying, if it's time for you to come, sit quiet with me. I want to talk with you. I want to give you what to do, give you direction. I want to instruct you. I want to discuss with you. God loves prayer. God loves discussion. It is in the midst of prayer that when you ask a question, you answer, you get intimate. You get close. Your true state of heart will be revealed. When God asks us question, he wants you to reveal who you are. That is why we have to trust God. God never called us to trust man. It was our decision to trust man. We went too far. God told us to love people. He said, love your neighbor as yourself. Including your pastor is your neighbor.
Yes.
I didn't see anybody in the Bible say love your pastor. I didn't see it there. But there are pastors that say love pastor. Love your pastor. Those are part of 48 laws of power. Because the love you give to that pastor, when he tells to give him, you turn to trust. We begin to trust man. The Bible says you are cursed. Jeremiah 17:5, Isaiah 2:22. Jeremiah 17:5, Isaiah 2:22. God never called us to trust any human being, including your husband.
Jeremiah 17:5.
Yes, sir.
Thus saith the Lord.
Thus saith the Lord.
The Lord.
Who is the one talking here?
The Lord.
When you hear thus saith the Lord, you put your ear down.
That's right. Cursed be the man.
The Lord said, cursed be the man. Whoever you are.
That's right.
Yes.
Cursed be the man that trusted
the man. Cursed be the man that put his trust in the fellow man.
And maketh flesh his arm.
You are making flesh. The one that goes to poo-poo. The one that gets hungry. The one that can sweat. The one that can have malaria. The one that can rub face, put face mask, put face shield. You are putting your trust in some kind of flesh. Yes.
Who and whose hearts depart from the Lord?
The Lord said, once you begin to trust human beings, I don't care who they are, I don't care your pastor, I don't care how they are billionaire, they are your mentor, they are your benefactor. Once you trust man, you are definitely cursed and you have departed from the Lord.
That's right.
A son receive grace in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
You have departed from the Lord automatically. It goes together. It goes for the pursuit. Once you are trusting man, you cannot see God. It is man that you'll be seeing. Whatever the man says, that is what you're going to take. You will never hear God. The two don't work together. All the mountains that cracked, all those noises, I thank God Elijah knew that God was not there. I thank God for that man of God. God Almighty will give that kind of spirit to know when God is speaking. Because God said he wants to use you and I to expose false preachers.
Amen.
He said, the more we are studying the word of God, the more we are receiving truth, like on this global altar and other altars that are great ministers of God there, like my daddy Chris, what you see, he's a great minister of God. These are truth preachers. As you begin to listen to all these great ministers of God that God has given this truth, you begin to see lights. Your eyes will be opening.
Amen.
Like the Berean church. Before you read Isaiah 2:22, like the Berean church in Acts 17:11.
Amen.
Your eyes will begin to open and you begin to know the truth. So when these false preachers are preaching, you can locate them.
Yes, sir.
You can resist them.
Yes, sir.
They will be exposed.
Amen.
You will not take anything that they say. Although their heretic interpretation of scripture, you will know that this one is lying. This is from the flesh. You can know that God is one. God is not three. You begin to, what does it say, Acts 17:11?
These we are more noble than those in Thessalonica.
The Bible said that a group of Christians, that we are more noble than other Christians.
That's right.
That went extra mile.
Yes,
yes.
In that they received the word with all.
Whenever they hear message,
They receive the word.
They receive the truth.
With all readiness of mind.
Their mind is open. They want to receive truth. They are sincere. They are genuine, like some of you. You are genuine. You go to the internet. You are looking for pictures that have the truth.
Right.
And some of you, when you came to Global Altar, your heart, you received a confirmation from the Holy Ghost that says, stay there.
Yes, sir.
That is where the truth is. Stay there.
Right.
And you began to receive truth. You began to come.
With all readiness of mind.
Your heart was ready. You came. You wanted to hear. You believed.
And search the scriptures daily.
They began to search. Whenever they hear the word, they don't fight in church. They don't raise hand and begin to contend with the pastor.
Uh-huh.
They say, thank you, sir. We have received your word.
Uh-huh.
We came for it to hear the word. They will go home. They will carry the jotter that they jotted.
Uh-huh.
Because many of us, all you know is to note, notation. Your name is notation officer. You know how to note. You don't go home and do a checklist. You don't check. That is why you cannot even do it. You cannot even be a doer of the word. Because you don't even have faith. What you have even written down, you don't even believe. The Bible says that we go and search
the scriptures daily.
They'll be searching. They will check it. They will check the notes. Okay, they said God is three gods. Is God three gods? I'm going to go and check. They will come confirm. No, God is not three gods. The Bible says in Deuteronomy 6:4 that
yes,
God is one God. That means Apostle Paul. Apostle Paul did not say it well. He cannot. They are not Paul. He didn't accept every teaching because they cared for their soul. They said daily.
Whether those things were so.
What they heard in church, they heard in the conference, they heard in that big program with big advertisement. Is it true? They didn't take their soul to become a merchandise. They didn't turn their soul to become a place of fun. They knew that the word of God has power enough to either make or destroy.
Yes.
And they wanted to be made by God.
Yes,
they knew that it was Jesus that died for them.
Yes.
Not any human being that died for them.
Yes.
They have gone through sickness.
Yes.
They have gone through situations. And it's like it was God that delivered them. They still wanted that God.
Yes.
They didn't want man. Keep your heart on Jesus.
Yes.
Remove your trust from man.
Yes.
Isaiah 2:22, son.
Isaiah chapter 2, verse 22.
Yes, sir.
Seize ye from man.
The Bible says withdraw.
Right.
Seize from man.
Yes.
Whose breath is in his nostrils?
Yes. See where his breath is. Yes.
For wherein he is he to be accounted of?
The Bible says he to be given account.
Yes.
You cannot open somebody who has breath here that can be closed.
Yes.
You cannot open somebody that snores more in the night.
Yes.
We serve a Jesus and another sleep not slumber.
Yes.
That is the one that we are to trust.
Yes,
do not trust a human being that
yes.
has for the God.
Yes, sir.
Don't trust a human being that has gone.
Yes,
we saw a God that can stay there and throw a stone and kill everybody.
Yes,
that one of his angels killed 185,000 in one night. That is the God that's following. That's God I'm trusting. His name is called the Lion of the tribe of Judah. Oh, Lion of Judah. My trust is in you.
Yes, sir.
The King of glorious you are. My trust is in you. The humble to the widow. My trust is in you. Oh, I put them all in you. Yes, I do. My trust is in you. Yeah, I put them all in you. Yes, I do. My trust.
The
title is, are you tired of waiting?
Mm.
Can you still wait on the Lord? Are you tired? God
God Almighty is calling us to a life of waiting on Him, not on any man. That is why you must beware, beware of any church that you see Christmas tree on the altar.
Yes, sir.
God is not in that church. Once you see Christmas tree in any church, God is not there. Move.
Yes.
Disappear.
Yes.
Pass the backyard.
Yes.
And run out.
Yes.
Jeremiah chapter number 10. Jeremiah 10, 1 to 4. God is not in that church that has Christmas tree on the altar.
Jeremiah chapter 10.
Now, verse 1 to 4.
Hear ye the word of the Lord.
Hear ye the word of Ikechi.
Hear ye the word which the Lord speaketh.
This is God's own message to his people.
Yes.
Who is he talking to?
Oh, house of Israel.
House of Israel is church. It's me and you.
Yes.
Yes.
Thus saith the Lord.
Thus saith the Lord. Look at him repeating up and down that he is the one talking.
Yes,
so he don't accuse me. Don't say it's my doctrine. Don't say I don't believe in Christmas. People of God, if there's any Christmas addicts, I was possessed by Christmas. I spent thousands of naira in Nigerian currency. I spent thousands on Christmas. I have big trees. I even put some things in the toilets. I put in the bathroom. I put in the kitchen. I put decoration everywhere. I am a Christmas fanatic. I'm worse than many, many people. I put Christmas stockings. I put sweet and chocolate inside. Do you know me on Christmas? Did you have manger? I bought manger.
Hey,
Kalabala. I had Christmas manger. I bought shepherd. All the shepherds were watching flocks. I bought them. I decorate my house with shepherds. I said, you are the one that saw Jesus. So stay here. I put light everywhere. Hey, Kalabokoso. Hey, do you know me? I do white Christmas, pink Christmas, blue Christmas, purple Christmas. I do all Christmases. Hey, Kalabuko. When you see me shouting, it's because the Lord said in Kechi, you are going to hell fire.
Yes.
And you are not worshiping me. You are worshiping Nimrod. You are worshiping Tammuz. You are worshiping Baal. I'm not in that arrangement. Christmas is not of God.
Yes.
Jesus was not born on Christmas day. I told him, we are going to declare it. That's the hard truth.
Amen.
Unbelievers know. Satan knows.
Yes.
We are the ones sponsoring them.
Yes.
Every December, Christians spend most of all the money that devil
that
uses to walk. All the money that devil uses to work the rest of the year, we are giving to him by the Christians. We gave him money. We sponsored him. All the apostles, we sponsored him because during Christmas is when you have the most fornication and adultery. Christians sponsor blood. So when we are talking here, it's not we that we are talking. We are speaking as God Almighty gave us utterance. We are obeying God. Christmas is a fun from hell,
yes, sir,
to make us feel good. It's a spell. That is when you talk about it. Listen, I composed song about Christmas. It's my Lord's birthday. I composed song. It's my Lord's birthday. I composed it many years ago. To tell you that me, my second name is Nkechi Christmas. I fought my husband because of Christmas clothes. If he doesn't give me money, we must quarrel. Christmas separate homes. Christmas bring discord. Divide homes. Christmas give you covetousness. Christmas brings competition spirit. You want to compare and contrast. Look at how this person is my husband. Gave her $1,000. You are just giving me $200. Christmas is a time when your brain goes away. You buy what you do not need. Christmas is a time of foolishness. Jesus cannot tell you to celebrate when you become mental. Our celebration of Christ gives us sound mind. It's called Holy Communion Service. We take communion before God, we are healed, we are delivered, we are restored, we are strong. God did not call us to other party spirits. God is talking to us about Christmas here.
That's right.
And all those your Easter, all those your days that you are celebrating. He says, what?
Thus saith the Lord.
Saith the Lord.
Learn not the way of unbelievers.
Follow the way of unbelievers.
And be not.
Yes, son.
And be not dismayed.
Be not dismayed at the signs of heaven. There are many heavens.
That's right.
Yes.
For the heathen are dismayed at them.
Yes.
For the customs of the people are vain.
This is a custom. My great grandmother, they call it Keresimesi.
Yes, yes.
Keresimesi.
They want to go down the day they cook a lot of fries and eat chicken, even without teeth in front. That's why they bring out the slippers that they bought for them from the beginning of the year. To go and compete in the church, I tell them, hey, my son bought the slippers for me. Christmas is not a time for Jesus Christ. It's a time of the flesh. When we want to look good and display the money we made from January. We work from January to November, finish the money in December, start January again to work. We are moving in circles. Useless life. Some people start to follow money. For school fees in January, when you are doing Christmas, you don't remember bills in future. Ready to withdraw all your savings.
Yes.
I thank God for my late mother before she went to be with the Lord. I remember when she was one Christmas, she said, my children, come, we came. It's not today. It's Christmas Day. We say we know. We are waiting for rice. Say, but today we are eating beans in this house. I want to know if without rice there will be no Christmas.
Hallelujah.
She cooked her beans.
Yes, sir.
People of God, Christmas Day is not a special day for us.
At all.
They are celebrating their thing. We celebrate every day.
Yes, sir. Hallelujah.
We celebrate God every day. Yes. Every day. To me, it's a day of joy. A lot of people put Christmas there. Because that Christ there, the Bible says there shall be many Christs. So that Christ will not be my Jesus Christ. Be not ignorant. Be not deceived. The devil is at ego. We are not his mates. He's 6,000 years of a senior. We cannot know more than him. He knows how to twist us. If he could twist Eve, who was a holy woman that was fellowshipping with God? Have you ever fellowshipped with God before in the garden? Have you ever heard from God? Eve was fellowshipping with God, yet she was deceived. Yet she ate from the devil's table. You will not know when you will eat from the devil's table. Why? Because the devil doesn't come with a dirty table. The Bible calls him the prince of this world. He's a prince. Satan is a prince. He's not a houseboy. He's not a worker. He can offer billions of dollars. The devil is rich. He can give good name. He can give you presidency. He can give GOs TV station. He can build auditorium for them. The devil is rich.
Thank you, Lord.
So when you begin to preach and tell people, Jesus died so that I be rich, don't deceive yourself so that I can offer riches.
Yes.
If being rich is a sign of prosperity, then the devil will offer the church.
Yes.
Because he has prosperity to offer.
Yes.
He offered Jesus,
yes,
who was in the spirit.
Yes.
He offered, I will give you all these things.
Yes.
Only worship me. Satan is looking for worship.
Yes.
He can use anything to get it.
Yes.
He chose Christmas Day.
Yes.
He chose Easter. He chose Valentine's Day. He chose Halloween. He chose Mother's Day, Father's Day, all the day, but no Judgment Day. Return, my child.
For the customs of the people are vain.
The custom Christmas is vain.
Yes.
For one cutted a tree out of the forest.
They entered the forest and cut tree.
The work of the hands of the workman.
They use their hand to work it.
With the axe.
They use axe and cut the tree.
They deck it with silver and gold.
They deck it with silver and gold.
They fasten it with nails.
They put they use nail to put it here, yes?
And with hammers that it move not.
Somebody say hammer.
Hammer.
Don't you use hammer for Christmas tree? Don't you think you're using hammer to arrange things? I have hammer. I have Christmas hammer. We hit things. We hit everywhere. I climb. If you need to see me climbing, I climb to hang my lights. You cannot come to my house on the 15th of December in those days. You don't see my Christmas. My children will come back and say, Mommy, what's happening? I can't smell Christmas. My children know me. I thank God for deliverance.
Yeah.
Yeah. I thank God for deliverance.
Yeah.
Oh, I am delivered. Praise the Lord. I am the leader.
not really for Jesus. So you put X, and X is variable.
Yes.
X is unknown. You know it is not for God. You want to have your fun. You want to enjoy your sex. You want to enjoy your movies, your parties. Forget about the Christmas, the so-called Jesus film that they are acting. That is not Jesus. If really that was the Jesus that they want to follow, that I want to celebrate, they will not come and sing that thing. They will go and cry. You cannot finish watching portion of the Christ and you can't come and sing.
Yeah.
If you really believe that is Jesus, but you see it as a Hollywood actor.
Yes.
You know the actor, you know other films he acted where he was kissing people up and down. The same man that went to kiss a poker to ask Jesus. And you put that picture in your house. You call it that is Jesus. Did you see the other film he acted? Did you see him having committed immorality in the other film? Because he acted Jesus. Then you put his picture in your house. God, the craving image, you are worshiping an idol.
Yes.
And God is going to judge.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
It is faith.
Yes.
That's right.
Yes.
They are upright as the palm tree.
They stand at palm tree.
But speak not.
They cannot speak.
They must need be born.
They must need be born. You must carry them. If you don't carry the Christmas tree, you cannot move.
That's right.
It's carryable.
That's right.
That's the God that you go and kneel on the altar. Once again, the Lord is warning. If you see any altar with Christmas tree, if you kneel down there, you're worshiping Tammuz.
Yes.
You're worshiping Baal. You're worshiping Baal.
Yes,
Jezebel is there.
Yes.
She's going to pour her cup of fornication on you. You will not see the glory of God. The little strength you have, they will collect it from your hand. So go back to Isaiah chapter 2. Read 20, verse 20. Go to verse 20. Isaiah 2, 20. The Holy Ghost said there is something there.
That's right. In that day, a man shall cast his idols of silver.
In that day, God of God. When the devil wants us to worship him, he comes with gold and silver.
That's right.
Yeah.
And his idols of gold.
Idols of gold.
Which they made each one for himself to worship.
They made it for themselves to worship. There is worship in silver and gold. That is why if you want any woman to hate you, talk her, to talk about her jewelry. Touch her gold. Touch her earring. Touch her bangle. Touch her necklace. She will eat you raw. Why? Object of worship are revered. You fight for what you worship. You defend what you worship.
Yes, son. To the moles and to the bats.
To the moles and to the
bats.
P A what?
T S.
What is bats to you? It's not a witch. When you begin to see bats, do you worship the Lord? Don't you plead the blood?
Yes.
Don't you get afraid?
Yes.
You only worship God when you see doves.
Yes.
That's how you worship God.
Yes.
There's even a bird that they will call Chekeleke in Nigeria.
Yes.
As a growing child, when they are passing, we say, Chekeleke, give me white finger. Chekeleke. And when you check, you will see white.
Yes.
It's a myth. But we believed, and it worked for us. We used to see it white, and then we will save it. We will save the finger. I go and show our parents. I say, Mommy, I saw Chekeleke. Ah, control the galantaya. I thank God for Jesus. Somebody thank God for Jesus. We are waiting on the Lord. Go to the book of Isaiah, chapter number 40. Isaiah 40, 28 to 31. Holy Ghost is here. Are you tired of waiting? Are you getting bored? Are you yawning in the spirit? 28 to 31, my child.
Hast thou not known?
Have you not known?
Hast thou not heard?
Haven't you heard?
That the everlasting God.
Everlasting God.
The Lord.
The Lord.
The creator of the ends of the earth.
No, the Lord.
The Lord.
No, there are three gods.
The Lord.
Child of God, we have one God. There is only a Trinity.
Yes.
Trinity is not of God.
That's right.
It's when people didn't understand God, they formed it.
Hey.
They say, well, who is Father? Who is Son? They now began to count Father, Son. They used physical things to represent God. They don't know that He's a spirit.
Hey.
And spirit cannot die.
At all.
He has to enter a human being. Yet He is the
Word.
To come and die and bring up blood. And that He's not lifeless. He's a spirit. So His spirit is God, Holy Spirit.
Yes.
there is one God. The Bible said that the Lord, the creator of the
earth, the ends of the earth,
yes,
fainteth not.
He does not faint.
Neither is weary.
He is not weak. He can take care of you.
Yes.
Child of God, that he can take care of us.
Yes, sir.
We can stay with him to the end.
Yes.
His name is called the Ancient of Days.
Hallelujah.
He knows when he's going to come.
Yes.
Bible says, he that shall come.
Yes.
He will not tarry. We are not of them that give up. Are you tired of waiting?
No.
I am not tired of waiting. The more I wait, the stronger I am. Read on, my child.
There is no searching of his understanding.
There is no searching of his understanding.
He giveth power to the faith.
He is the one that gives power, not the anointing oil that they give in church.
Yes, sir. Thank you, Lord.
One of my daughters the other day called me from Morocco and said, Mommy, I'm not feeling well. I want you to call me and bless my olive oil. I smiled. I said, Lord, give me grace to bring her up in your faith.
Amen.
To the glory of God today, I didn't pray for the oil, but she's strong.
Yes,
I gave her the word of God.
Hallelujah.
I taught her how to pray.
Yes,
I called, I said, come, let's pray. And we prayed together on Zoom. We prayed about how to grow in the Lord. Her faith began to grow. I didn't pray over the oil, and yet God healed her. Child of God over there, the Lord God Almighty, He is the one that gives us power.
Yes.
And He gives us by faith.
Yes.
Even that holy communion, you can eat it in your house.
Yes.
You do not need to eat the holy communion, you don't know who prepared it.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. All the people are going to eat it with you. Raka lepo kosunda la galanta ya. Raka la baba yada. For every 12, there's a Judas.
Yes.
As soon as Judas put his hand inside that plate, the spirit of the devil entered him, and he went to want to kill Jesus. Child of God, beware of general food.
Yes, sir.
Thank you.
He is one of his power. Man who feeds you in your dream.
Yes.
Satan can come using a familiar face that you cannot reject.
Yes.
To feed you poison.
Yes.
You wake up, you cannot pray.
Yes.
You wake up, everything about God has disappeared.
Yes.
You forget your consecration. You start getting tired.
Yes.
You start masturbating. All your testimonies you gave about how God delivered you from pornography will disappear.
Yes.
The Lord will restore you now.
Yes.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Yes.
The Bible says he gives power
to the faint.
The Lord will give us power this season.
Amen.
This season of soul strength, TSS, the Lord will give us power.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Yes.
And to them that have no might.
We have no might. We don't have power. We don't have anybody to talk for us. Our children are helpless. The Lord God Almighty said what? He will do what?
Increase our strength.
He is going to give us increase. Somebody say increase.
Increase.
This season of soul strength, those things that were making you cry, you overcome them.
Yeah.
Those things that you thought that you could not overcome, you cannot do without eating, you cannot do without eating. Your husband doesn't greet you, you cry. God said, your husband will not greet you, I will still test you. I will still make him not to greet you, but you will have your joy.
Amen.
You have increased strength.
Amen.
Your joy will not rest in the husband. It will not rest in children. I know what I'm passing through. The Lord is testing me. With everything that I like, the Lord is withdrawing. The Lord is testing me to see if without those things I can still have joy. Oh, I still have joy. I still have joy. After all I've been through, fire, I still have joy. Oh, I still have joy. Oh, I still have joy. After all I've been through, I still have joy. Child of God has increased strength. There is increased strength.
Amen.
I will not miss it.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Read on, child.
Even the youth shall faint and be weak.
The Bible says, even youth shall faint. Are they not fainting? Are you not seeing what's happening to youths? They have departed from the Lord. They are not seeking God. All they are looking for is relationship. Making of money, doing all the bets, all the lotteries, all the casinos, all the clubbing, increasing their strength for sex. Are you know that if youths are fainting, you cannot see, you hardly see a youth that can stand for 1 hour and pray. Even 30 minutes is a challenge. Because
because their mind is saturated with relationship.
Yes,
they don't sleep in the night. They chat till morning. Chatting with girls. They send their private part. That girl they are sending a private part. Do you know that whether she's a queen of the ghosts? Yeah. When you send her your private part, and she gives it to her mother in the water. Do you know what they do with your private part? God is delivering youth. Youth have been set free. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. All of your wet nights, you sleep and you're sleeping with a girl in your dream. You wake up, you feel empty, you feel useless, you feel like committing suicide. God is releasing deliverance. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Child of God, remember that the youth can faint.
And the young men shall utterly fall.
They shall utterly, the young men will fall. I don't see what happened to preachers. Because they cannot wait on God. And receive strength from God and hear from God. They are going to meet witch doctors. They go and sleep with marine spirits in the rivers, in the beach, in the night. They are women that they give them in the night to sleep with them in the river. I'm telling you true life stories. I'm not joking here. They go extra mile just to make it. They want to answer millionaire in their 30s. They want power. Where people be kissing their feet, kneeling down for them. The Bible says they shall utterly fall because they are falling already. They are carrying them to prison. They are dying. They are beating their wives.
Yes.
To the point of death.
Yes.
Many things are happening now because the youths have gone the other way because of pushing of most pastors for them to go and bring money for them. The pastors will be pushing them. Then go and make money. When you make money, you are going to buy jets. You are going to do this. You are going to do that. And because they saw the way the pastor promoted the others that did it, they are pushed to go and do it. God told me, Kechi, my problem is the pastors. They are my problem. And until these false preachers are exposed by you and I, there will be no peace in the world. There will not be peace. The churches will be struggling. Youths will be struggling. I know what I'm hearing in the hearts of youths. I see what youths are passing through. They cannot serve God. They are confused. They are frustrated. Yet when they come to the front of the church, they lift their hands in the air and be singing songs. And be saying, it's all right. I've got a feeling everything's gonna be all right. Nothing is all right. They are still pornography.
Yes.
They are still masturbating. They are secretly committing abortions to cover their image in the church. Have you finished my time?
But they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength.
Even though youth faint, the young utterly fall. There is a but.
Hallelujah.
But they
that wait upon the Lord.
They, my name is there.
My name is there.
Ikechi is there. Is your name there?
Yes, sir.
Ify is your name there?
Yes, sir.
Ellen is your name there?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, is your name there?
Yes, sir.
But
they
wait upon Daddy God.
Shall renew their strength.
They shall be renewed. Their strength shall be renewed.
They shall mount up with wings as eagles.
They shall mount up. They shall mount up.
With wings.
Listen. Not that somebody is going to carry them with holy oil. Because they are receiving their personal strength.
Yes, sir.
They will know how to encourage themselves in the Lord. They will know how to stand in the truth. They will know how to resist the devil. And as they are going through that process of strength with God, they shall mount up like a balloon. And he's looking flabby. I begin to blow the balloon. It begins to blow. It begins to increase. And enlarge. And enlarge. And you can lift it and it will go. It will fly. This is not the flying of a witch.
Thank you, Holy Ghost.
This balloon has stuff. Something is inside that balloon.
Yes, sir.
It's got power. That is why the most expensive means of transport is the air.
Yes, sir.
I don't know anybody that's talking about air doesn't take picture. Hey, when I talk about, they take picture. They don't take picture with train. Yeah, they don't take with bus. They take with air. And they put it there. We are going on missions. The Lord is faithful. They either take when they are entering. the plane or when they're coming out or when they're inside. And social media must get it. It's the highest means of transport. It's the most expensive. There is stuff that carries the plane up.
Yes, sir.
It is the there is something in the air. There is a sustainer. It's not a human being. It's not in the hand of the pilot. That is when it crashes, pilot to dies. It's in the hand of somebody. It's the pillar that holds our lives. It's our strengthener, our enabler, our helper. Allow them to gossip.
Yes,
allow them to persecute.
Yes,
allow them to hate you. Haters are down. Haters are your best fans.
Yes,
hey, because they are the one monitoring you.
Yes,
they want to provide you.
Yes,
God use haters to help you to adjust.
Yes,
when haters abuse me, God is telling me, check what they are saying and correct it.
Yes,
I am not moved. I cannot hate haters. I wish I can give them gifts.
Because
they are the ones that are giving me reason to keep pushing.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Child of God. Upstairs is where we belong to.
Yes, sir.
We have no business here. Down is crowded. It's like answers. Black life matter. Down is filled with rioters. It's filled with competitors. There's no competition over there. Up there is the shining place. You are running with Christ. You are seated with Him in heavenly places. Using makeup.
Yes, sir.
Only few don't make up. They are the ones up there.
Hallelujah.
They are noticed by God.
Yes,
don't worry about the pouring hair to be that general place.
Yes,
when you see in the midst of 10 women, 9 are wearing trousers. They are down.
Yes.
The only one wearing trousers is up.
Yes,
child of God, God is calling us to exceptional life.
Yes,
to difference.
Thank you, Holy Ghost.
In those days, I used to feel bad when I was, you know, growing as a teenager. Because I've always been tall. I've never been short. I'm always a tall girl from childhood. In fact, at the age of 9 months, my mother said I was taller than my baby bed.
Yeah.
I was taller than my bed. I had to start sleeping with her on her big bed. I've never been a short girl. I am 6'3". If I stand up here now, the camera, they have to adjust it.
Yes.
I used to feel bad when they be singing for me. Ogologo Dimba, Ogologo Dimba, Ogologo, that's tall, 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 that's what interpret what does it mean? Ogologo Dimba. But now, when I get up, I lift up my head. I've understood that my head should stand, not to bend. Whenever I enter anywhere, I don't care who you are, you must notice in Kechi.
Yes, sir.
And once you notice me, you will see my Jesus.
Yes, sir.
You will see my long dress.
Yes, sir.
You will see my beautiful face. And you will begin to know that this person is a is other Jesus. This person is a different child. I'm not like others. I am proud of my heart. And even at 51 plus, almost 52 years, I am still getting taller. I've increased in height. Even if I wear flat shoes, I'm still very, very tall. And I'm very happy. Why? Short people are intimidated. Short men cannot chase me. And there are no men tall men. Very few tall men. When they look at my height, they know that this is not another person. This person will be married to God. Hallelujah. Don't be tired of waiting on Daddy God. Daddy God is able to carry us through. He is worthy of our waiting. Don't be weak. Don't be tired. Don't mind the mockery. He said, we shall mount up with wings as eagles.
They shall run and not be weary.
We are running. We are in our race. There is time to fly. Now you are running. We shall run.
And not be weary. And they shall walk and not faint.
We shall walk and not faint. Amen. God Almighty said, they that walk with him. Hallelujah. But he that walketh with the Lord. There is a walking with God.
Yes,
Enoch walks with God.
Yes.
Until both of them vanish. Yes. We are running a race because there is a price. For there is a thing we are waiting for.
Yes.
It's called rapture alerts. Rapture alerts. Rapture alerts. Rakalabo kusubaya. You know when the days that people are adding to the word of God, they are adding, they are subtracting. So I go to the book of Deuteronomy. Lakalepo kusuta lagalata lagalata. Lekalabo kusuta lagalifa kusuta lagalata. 4:2. Then Revelation 22:18-19. Show me 4:2. People add and they subtract. They're not saying what God is saying. They add their own. The Bible says we shall mount up.
Yes, shall not add unto the word.
Don't add to the word of God.
Which I command you.
Which God is commanding us.
That's right.
Yes.
Neither shall you diminish us from it.
Don't remove any jots.
Yes,
don't add your own. Don't say God says we should have moderate jewelry. There's nothing like moderate jewelry. You added it.
Yes.
You are the one adding things. Don't add.
Yes.
Don't remove.
Yes.
Is it finished?
That ye may keep the commandments of the Lord your God.
So that he will keep God's commandments.
Which I command you.
Which he has commanded us.
Yes.
If you add, you'll be distorted. Yes. You'll be perverted. Yes. You'll be corrupted. Yes. You'll be spoiled. Yes. Don't add to God's word.
Yes.
Don't subtract.
Yes.
Christmas is addition.
Yes.
You are adding.
Uh-huh.
You are adding what God did not say.
Yes.
He never asked us to celebrate his birth.
Yes.
All these lies, is to promote single parenthood.
Yes.
And they say, round young virgin mother and child. Where is Joseph there?
Hey.
They didn't put Joseph. They want to legalize single motherhood.
Yes.
They want to legalize that you can have a child outside wedlock and you be recognized. They don't recognize God. Hey, but Jesus always talked about God. I mean, he called Mary. You say Mary, mother. You call him woman. Well, how many times did he call Mary and publicize Mary? But it wasn't my father.
Yes.
But the son Carol has said, round young virgin mother and child. No room for God. No room for even the earthly father. The Joseph, the one that God used to preserve shame.
Yes.
That shame will not come upon the people of God.
Yes.
There's no recognition of Joseph. They want you to feel that you can have a child as I will look. And yet we celebrate it. That's why we have baby mama. Baby mama. And they are boastful about it. They come and say, my baby mama, my baby papa, father.
Uh-huh.
They are celebrating immorality.
Yes.
Celebrating fornication.
Yes.
Celebrating single motherhood. What's supposed to be a thing of shame?
Yes.
In those days, if you have a child, you hide the child.
Yes.
Give it to your mother.
Yes.
And go to the city.
Yes.
But now it is advertised. Yes. God Almighty said he's returning back his children to have sense.
Amen.
To the place of honor.
Amen.
Go to the next chapter, verse 11. Show me 5:11. Before I go to Revelation, my child.
Chapter 5, verse 11.
Yes, sir.
Thou shalt not take the name of the Lord thy God.
Thou shalt not put God, Christ, Jesus Christ, inside your hidden celebration.
Yes, sir.
Don't call his name in vain.
Yes, sir.
For the Lord will not hold you guiltless.
God said, I will deal with you.
That take his name in vain.
I will punish you. I will give you disease. I will give accidents. Rakalabokosoda. I will crash that your plane. Akundalaya. That your jet. I will crash it. Rakalab. Don't take my name in vain. Don't spoil my name. Don't attribute my name to rubbish. Don't go and divorce and say, thank God for a successful divorce. You are taking the name of the Lord in vain. You are insulting God who said, I hate divorce. Don't go and use your fake certificate to get a job and say, the Lord has given me a job. What the Lord has done for me, I cannot tell it all. Of course, I cannot tell it all. Will you tell me that that certificate is a fake certificate? That your passport is a fake passport? And you're using somebody's name to walk? God Almighty, don't take my name in vain. It's time for us to address our lives. Tell them, examine your life. There's a rapture alert. Go to the book of Revelation. Revelation 22:18-19.
Why testify unto every man that heareth the words of the prophecy of this
book. The Holy Ghost is talking. He said what?
For I testify unto every man.
I testify unto every man, every preacher, every bishop, every man of God, every prophet, whoever you are. This word is for you.
That hearing the words of the prophecy of this book.
As you are hearing the prophecy, this word of God, the Bible calls it prophecy.
That's right.
Child of God, beware of what is the prophecy you're following. For looking for, can I prophesy? Prophesy. Those are charlatans.
Yes.
All the prophecies, they're all charlatans. Child of God, as much as prophecy is good, right now, the one we can trust now is this sure word.
Yes.
This one is fixed.
Yes.
It's sealed.
Yes.
Whatever said to the heaven.
Yes.
Nothing can spoil this one. This one spoil the message. Rakalabokoso. It's a letter to you and I.
Yes.
This is our text message.
Hallelujah.
This one is our WhatsApp. This is our WhatsApp from God. God WhatsApp it to us. God tweeted it to us.
What
did he say?
If any man shall add unto these things.
If any man except the bishops.
If any man.
But they are reverence.
If any man.
They wear big caps.
If any man.
Fat rings.
Amen.
Once you see picture with fat rings, Satan is there.
Yes.
God. The Lord cannot give them ring.
No.
When he is not wearing. He's not wearing, he gave them ring. And they're supposed to be representing him. They didn't tell them to wear ring. Who gave them that cross? They're wearing their neck. It's easy to wear a cross, but we are told to carry it.
Yes.
Pick up your cross.
Thank you,
not bear cross.
Yes.
You can wear cross and not bear it.
Yes.
Bear the cross, carry it.
Yes,
it's a duty. Carry your cross and be following Jesus.
Yes,
don't wear it and deceive people that you are holy. Makunda laga libro kosunda laga lanta laga ya. The Bible says what? If any man, it doesn't matter who you are, it doesn't matter your posts, how they hail you in the world. If any man shall add
unto these things,
where God said these three shall be one. If I put persons there. In 1 John 5:7,
yes.
He said that bear record that the Father, the Word, and the Spirit are one.
Mm.
These three are one. You go and put three persons and put it in the song. There's only like three persons in the Bible. There's only like God the Father. You don't pray in God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Ghost. You pray in the name of Jesus Christ,
yes.
Not IJM.
Yes.
Not IJMN. You pray in the name of Jesus Christ, or Lord Jesus.
Yes.
You don't pray as the name of God the Father. You don't call titles. You're not told. So go pray in the name. That's John 14:14. Pray in the name. There's a name above every other name. It's in the book of Philippians chapter 2. That name is above every name. It's in the name of Jesus Christ. Every knee shall bow. Pray in the name of Jesus Christ. Child of God, beware of churches that pray with God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Ghost. They are Trinitarians.
Yes.
No Trinitarian is going to heaven.
Yes.
Anyone who calls three gods cannot enter. They cannot cross. The heaven is sealed to them.
Yes.
That's word of God. They are adding. God didn't say so. They are adding.
Yes,
go ahead.
God shall add unto him the plagues.
God said all the plagues here. All the plague of suffering, all the plague of lice, locusts, all the plague of death, all the curses in Genesis 28, all of them, I will add to the person's life.
And if any man shall take away from the
and
words
if
of
any
the book,
man
shall, take
shall
away,
remove
from the world.
They feel like they don't like it. This one is too hard. People will leave the church. They remove it. Even though it is there, they don't preach it. They have removed it. When you don't preach the word of God, you have removed something.
Yes.
What did God say?
And if any man shall take away from the words of the book of this prophecy,
yes,
God shall take away his part.
God said, there's no heaven. You will not make heaven. Heaven is close. Your mansion will be there. Your members will come if they make it. And they will see your name there. But you cannot be there. Because everyone that has a mansion in heaven, the name is on it.
Yes, sir.
There is space. God doesn't give people another person's mansion. So when you go there, you know who made it. My name will not be missing. I will occupy my own mansion. I will not be a mockery. I will not be a laughing stock. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, let them pray these prayers, child of God. The Bible says if you do not preach the full gospel, you hang only on grace, grace, and prosperity. You do not preach on holiness and truth and character. And how would you prepare for heaven? The Bible says you cannot make heaven. You have removed from the word of God. 2 Timothy chapter number 2, verse 24.
2 Timothy chapter 2, verse 24.
Yes, sir.
And the servant of the Lord must not strive.
And the servant of the Lord
must not strive.
You must not quarrel with God's word.
That's right.
You must not fight holiness with us. When God uses anybody like he used a donkey to talk to his prophet, you must honor that person.
Yes. Right.
You don't flog a person.
Yes.
You don't hate a person. You don't preach against a person. You know that the person talking nonsense because you are not the one God told the person the message.
But be gentle unto all men.
Be gentle unto all men.
Ask to teach.
Don't bring bodyguards to beat people because they want to touch you.
Okay.
Be gentle unto all men like Jesus.
Right.
And then what is the other part?
Ask to teach.
Be ready to teach the accurate word of God.
Right.
Teach them based on God's principle. Don't teach people based on the 48 laws of power.
Uh-huh.
Once again, go and look for that book. You will see your pastor there. You will see his character is there. That is what most world powers are using. The Lord is exposing them at this global altar. Nobody can touch his message. Their secret is out. They have used it to deal with God's people. Put people in bondage. Put them inside cupboard. Lock it. And then other ones, people are like dolls. People have been brainwashed, cloned. People are living a life that they don't know what they are living. They won't even take the fascination yet. But their DNA is already distorted. They are not themselves. But God will release his children.
Amen.
God will set his children free.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Child of God, rapture alert is on. We are going to pray today. Revelation chapter 3, verse 10. And there is a wrath that is to come. But God said his children will escape it.
Amen.
Revelation chapter 3. Verse number 10. Revelation. Then 1 Thessalonians chapter 5.
Revelation chapter 3 verse 10.
Yes.
Because I have kept the word of my patience.
Yes.
I also will keep thee from the hour of temptation.
Because thou hast kept the word of my patience.
I also will keep thee from the hour of temptation.
While we are here on soul strength, is able to keep God's word. Because there's an hour of temptation.
Yes,
child of God, the great tribulation will be started. It has already started small. But it's going to come. It is while we are in it that the Lord will carry us away from the very serious wrath, because the great tribulation will be very, very tough. But those of us who by his grace believe God, believe in holiness, as we are following God, what did he say? Obey? Did he tell you what, like obey there? Yeah? Or follow? Read it again, son.
Because thou hast kept the word of my patience.
When you keep, it means obey.
That's right.
It means you follow, you believe. You are obeying the word of his patience. The Bible says you shall escape.
That's right. I also will keep thee from the hour of temptation which shall come upon all the world.
I will preserve you. That's it. Hour of temptation is coming.
Right.
People are going to see it. That's why they will say, hey, I heard you too. Hey, I heard you too. You and I will escape.
Amen.
That anger to come. That temptation to come, you and I will escape it.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Go to the book of 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, 1 to 11.
1 Thessalonians chapter 5,
1 to 11.
I read from verse 1.
Yes.
But of the times and the seasons,
uh-huh.
Brethren,
yes.
Ye have no need that I write unto you.
The Lord said, No, you cannot know God's coming by seasons.
That's right.
God will show us the secret of how to know Him.
Amen.
Read.
For yourselves know perfectly that the day of the Lord so cometh as a thief in the
night. The Lord said His day will come as a thief. Yeah. Unexpected.
That's right.
It may be on your birthday. Yeah. It can even be on your birthday. It can be on Christmas Day. And if there's a Christmas tree in your house, you're not going. If God catch you with anything Christmas in your house, you're celebrating Christmas, and He comes as a thief that day, because God catch you the day to come.
Yes.
Do nobody know the day, not the hour? It can be any day. It can be on that day that you want to relax. Somebody say relax.
Relax.
We don't relax. We are mounting up.
Yes.
And when we mount up, we maintain that place. We don't shake from there. We maintain that place. Read on.
For when they shall say peace and safety.
Now you are hearing preachers shouting peace, safety, all is well. You are going to be blessed. You are going to have this. Your prosperity is coming. Oh, you are hearing peace, safety. Yes.
Then sudden destruction comes.
Destruction is going to come suddenly, without notice.
That's right.
Like a woman that can't come with child.
Has travel upon a woman with child.
Hey, can I have
and they shall not escape.
Can we finish talking? Hey, can I? So this is the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
I didn't know that was the next verse. But the Lord told me, Ketchi, he must not cram anything here. Just come and sit down here. Let me sit on you. I didn't know that was going to happen. But look at how it. I just remembered my own labor. The Holy Ghost, I gave you praise. I worship you. The Bible says, as a woman, as a child upon a woman with child,
and they shall not escape.
The Lord said, when that time will come, people will not escape who are not following His way. Child of God, endure the mockery now.
Yes, that.
Don't be tired of holiness.
Yes,
come and put into deeper work with God.
Yes,
don't be tired of what God is doing in our lives. It may look as if it is stressful. All this fasting, all this prayer, there is a day that fasting will cease.
Yes,
when our God will take us there.
Yes,
there will be no fasting. There will be no Bible study. It shall be a long day of joy. There's no night there. Oh, there's a song that said there will be no night there. It just came to my heart and disappeared. There'll be no night there. God Almighty will give us a beautiful long day.
Amen.
A day of joy.
Amen.
A day I will begin to say, oh, you made it. Oh, you made it. Oh, I don't know how many hours. There's no hour there. It's eternity. I don't know how we are going to be welcoming each other. You come to my mansion, I will come to your mansion.
Hey.
And the Bible says we should comfort one another with these words. These are the things we use to encourage ourselves. Not when we don't get married. Your mates are married. When are we going to eat your cake? Come, let us have a doctor that will give you IVF. That's what Christians are discussing.
That is it.
That's what I did. Have you registered? Are we registered with long rich? You don't want to be rich? Can't hear the name long rich?
Long.
Is your richness to be long? God Almighty, someone will sit and say, I said, how is the race? How are you doing in the Lord? What was your last Bible study like? What book did you read this time? Did the Lord speak to you? This is a discussion of the saints of God. Not babe. I had that guy now. How is that guy? God Almighty is calling us a clean life.
Amen.
That is why holiness people, we are different.
Yes.
We are separated. They call you proud. They say you are high-minded. That is not pride. That is separation.
Yes.
That is the will of God for these people. But there shall be a separation of God and sheep.
Yes.
The Bible says they shall not escape.
That's right.
But ye, brethren, we are not in darkness.
That day should overtake you as a thief.
That day will not overtake us.
Amen.
God will show us. There's a secret question me about how we are going to know His coming. There's a secret. The Bible says what?
Ye are all the children of
light. All the children of light.
And the children.
Are you a child of light?
Yes.
Are you of the day?
Yes, sir.
So you cannot hide your phone. You don't need password. Don't hide anything. Be confidential. Don't support people in the secrets. I see some of you, I don't want to call some of you. Some of you that I see on global altar, God tells me your secrets. When I enter such a meeting, God say, go here. I will go. I will see what people are doing there. I was a child, Lord, have mercy on this, your daughter. If I call, some of you will be shocked here. If I call your name, call your problem on social media. I see what you're doing. All your false prophets that you're following, the Lord has shown me. All your things you are doing, God is revealing them. For God will bring you out.
Amen.
You will come out of darkness.
Amen.
That's your secret thing that you are doing. Nobody don't want anybody to know. You will come out.
Amen.
Child of God, the only way to know that you're a child of light is for people to be able to God, tell God, Father, tear my heart and show people.
Father,
if you can tell God to show people your heart, then you are making heaven.
Amen.
If people can see your secrets, what you do in the bedroom, people can see the things you watch on social media, you don't mind people seeing it, then child of God, you are heaven bound. But if you are doing something and somebody is entering, you change channel, you switch it off, you turn off your phone is always black when somebody is entering, but you are busy with it too. But when somebody came, it's now black. God doesn't look like nothing. I need to deal with my children. I said,
hey,
what are you doing there? Okay. I monitor them. What are you doing there?
Yeah.
I know, mommy, I'm not. I say, you're doing something there. I say, sorry, your mind changed.
Okay.
The Lord will restore his people from spirit of occultism.
Oh, yeah.
Hiding, doing this. Jesus Christ never did anything secret. That's why he died openly. He died on the cross. Hey.
My Lord.
He died open. They removed his pants. He was stark naked. Don't mind those things you are seeing that they're posting Jesus with pants. That is not the Jesus. The real Jesus was stark naked. Because they removed pants. They removed everything. He was stark naked. He was in shame until the Bible says that Joseph of Arimathea, he came and brought cloth and wrapped him and carried him. People of God, God Almighty is calling you and I to live a life of lights, transparency. Stop acting drama in church. Stop gossiping in your heart. You are in the church, you are seeing what is going on. Instead of you to come out and cry to God in the place of prayer, you sit there and pretend, I mean laughing, but in your heart you are complaining. You are a hypocrite. Hey, hypocrite. The Bible says what?
We are not of the night, not of darkness.
Not of darkness.
Therefore, let us not sleep.
Therefore, don't sleep, because people don't sleep in the night.
Yes,
the Bible in the book of John chapter 9 verse 4, Jesus said, I must work the works of him that sent me. While it is day, the night cometh when no man can walk. Child of God, there's a night coming. It can be the era of age. It can be the era of death.
Yes, sir.
Don't assume it will live forever.
Uh-huh.
That's the way, before you, when you are planning anything, say, if Jesus tarries, if God permits, by his grace.
Yes,
but I hear Christians that they plan for 10 years to come.
Yeah.
They plan for birthdays without considering whether their night will come before day. The Lord God Almighty will deliver us from pride in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Read your songs.
Therefore, let us not sleep as do all.
Don't sleep. People are sleeping.
Yes, sir.
There's activity. There's earthquake. There are programs. They are making music. They are jumping. Anaga. It is happening. Is it working? If nothing is working, they are sleeping. Raka lepo kosundala. No lockdown. They are already locked down. Raka lepo. They are locked down. Raka. They are sleeping. They are lost. Raka lepo. But they cannot even pray. Comfortable praying for in tongues for 1 hour. They can't. Raka la 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 la. They are sleeping. The Bible says what?
But let us watch and be sober.
Let us watch. Don't be tired of watching. Be sober. God is looking for sober children. None of them are looking for excitement of the world. You don't have enough excitement, my people of God. This is a time for us to be sober and watchful. Yes.
For they that sleep in the night.
They that sleep in the night. Where are you, son?
Verse 7.
Yes.
And they that be drunken are drunken in the night.
They drink in the night. Drunkenness is in the night. Yes.
But let us, who are of the day,
I am of the day,
be sober.
Be sober. Again, that word is coming again. When God begins to repeat a word several times, it means take note of it.
Yes.
It is urgent.
Yes.
It is for you.
Yes.
He will live if you do this. God is a loving Father. Thank you, Jesus, for loving us.
Thank you, Jesus.
Let us treat God as God, not as dog. So before, treat God as dog. How do you treat God? How do you treat God? Like a G-O-D or D-O-G. How do you treat God? I ask you again. How do you treat God? How do you treat God? Like a G-O-D or D-O-G. How do you treat God? I give you my prayer point. I give you 3 days. That's how you treat God. It's a bingo. Come on, T-O-G. That's how you're treating God. That's why I give him this, that he will give you miracle. That's why you are praising God because of what he will get. When you begin to praise God because of your miracle that you want to get, it's a D-O-G.
That's right.
You are making me talk. Yeah, you are not worthy of my praise. If you want me to praise you, do something for me. You are paying him to praise, to give you something with praise. You are using praise as currency to give him. You don't praise him for who he is. You don't praise him for his mightiness. You don't praise him for his excellent greatness. You are praising him because you are looking for ordinary child. Yeah, who can even hinder you from making heaven? That's why you are praising God. You are a merchant. You're not fit for God. The whole world has left God. The whole world is serving God for selfish motive. Serving God for satanic motive. You're not serving God because of who he is. God Almighty said, I'm looking for people to take me as God. Treat me as God. Have you finished, son?
Putting on the breastplate of faith and love.
Put on the breastplate of faith and love.
And for an helmet, the hope of salvation.
Your salvation is helmet, not your financial status. Not your position in society. Helmet is what you use to identify somebody's position and rank. And what God wants you to identify us is our salvation. You say, put on what? Your helmet of salvation, the hope of salvation.
The hope of salvation.
For God
has not appointed us to wrath.
Yes, sir.
But to obtain salvation by our Lord.
Our salvation is not by being a church member.
Uh-huh.
You can be a church member, you're not having salvation.
Yes,
there. It's not by title. You obtain salvation by our Lord Jesus Christ.
Who died for us?
Who died for us?
That whether we wake or sleep.
Whether we are awake,
we should live together with him.
We should be together with him. Live with him.
That's right. Verse 11 and the last.
Yes.
Wherefore, comfort yourselves together.
Comfort yourself.
And edify one another.
Ah, hallelujah.
Comfort yourself.
Yes, sir.
Be comforted, child of God. Be comforted. The Lord said, let us comfort ourselves.
Hallelujah.
When we comfort ourselves like this, we cannot gossip each other.
Yes.
I cannot hate you, cannot hate me.
Yes.
I will pray for you, pray for me.
Yes.
Yeah.
Right.
You should edify.
Yes.
Edify. Teach me. Mm-hmm. Correct me.
Yes.
Let us walk together. Don't look down on me because you corrected me and I took your correction.
Yes.
Because somebody said because I corrected you, therefore you're not spiritual.
Yes.
Don't look down on me. Don't say I'm not spiritual because you corrected me and I took your correction. That I took your correction is a sign of I am humble and I love you.
Yes.
And you love my soul.
Yes.
Don't use it against me.
Yes.
I need more people to correct me. When you see me going astray, call me and say, Sister Ketchi, no, don't do that. And God Almighty will tell me, listen to her.
Yes.
That is the life of a child of God.
Yes, sir.
The Lord God Almighty is calling us today that it is time for us to begin to serve him and love him as God.
Yes.
Treat him as God. Is there another scripture? Macaulay, another verse. Thessalonians 1, 9 and 10.
1 Thessalonians chapter 1,
9 and 10.
9 and 10.
Yes, sir.
For they themselves show of us what manner of entering
in
we had unto you.
Yes.
And how ye turned to God from idols.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I don't give a testimony how I turned to God from Christmas.
Yes.
Idol. Yes.
To serve the living.
To serve the living. Not the one that is in tree, not that you nail. I use all the hammer to eat.
That's right.
Not those gypsies, not those fairies that I hung on the tree. I'm serving the living God, the true and the living God.
Amen.
Hey,
and to wait for his son from heaven.
Someone say wait.
Wait.
Someone say wait.
Wait.
Who are we waiting for?
His son from heaven.
We are waiting for Jesus.
That's right.
From heaven. Will be
raised. He raised from
yes.
the dead.
Yes.
Who's Jesus?
Jesus.
Which delivered us from the wrath to come.
There is a wrath to come. And a living God. There is a wrath to come. I don't care what they're saying. I am after this wrath. I don't want it. Jesus has come and he will deliver us.
Amen.
We will be delivered.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Child of God, the Lord is calling out today that there is something in you that was going to be. Chichichim, to tell us that it is time. Matthew 3:2, Luke 17:20. Matthew 3:2. Luke 17:20. Look at the time. Mark, the gospel. Gospel is sweet.
Mark chapter 3, verse 2.
Yes.
And say, repent ye.
Repent ye.
For the kingdom of God is at hand.
For the kingdom of God is at hand. Child of God, the Bible says the kingdom of God is what is inside of you and I.
Yes, sir.
When you repent, true repentance will give you a check inside.
Yes, sir.
To be able to wait for that kingdom.
Yes.
Without repentance is a secret. Pick a secret. Repentance, true repentance is the secret to knowing the coming of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Because when the kingdom of God is in you, when you have received the kingdom of God, who is Jesus Christ? Go to the next chapter. Luke 17.
Luke chapter 17, verse 20.
What does it say?
And when he was demanded of the Pharisees,
yes,
when the kingdom of God should come,
uh-huh,
he answered them and said,
yes,
the kingdom of God cometh not with observation.
It's not observation. It's not by saying whatever thing is happening. Yes.
That's right. 21.
Yes.
Neither shall they say, lo here,
uh-huh,
or lo there.
Uh-huh.
For behold, the kingdom of God is within you.
Child of God, the kingdom of God is within us in Christ Jesus. If you have genuinely received Jesus, you cannot leave him.
Mm-hmm.
You will hold on to him.
Mm-hmm.
That is what will carry us to wait for him.
Yeah.
Waiting on the Lord with ordinary flesh, you'll be weak.
Mm-hmm.
By observing things, you'll be tired.
That's right.
If it is by COVID-19, you think Jesus will just come with COVID-19, you'll be tired because COVID-19 will finish and he has not come.
Mm-hmm.
You wait on the Lord by the Christ in you, the hope of glory.
That's right.
Yes. That is the kingdom of God. It's with us.
Mm-hmm.
You are conscious of him.
Right.
You want to honor him in your life.
Right.
You want to serve him in holiness and in righteousness. Child of God, it helps you to wait on him.
Right.
Waiting on the Lord is the secret of making heaven at last.
Right.
You keep on renewing. Keep on changing the old skin. You keep on getting stronger and stronger. Keep on seeing the glory of God. You keep on having more and more assurance of Christ. You keep on appreciating him in your life. That is, it's not only by him. It's not by prophecy. Don't mind only prophecy. Prophecy of his coming. They will quote dates. God said, don't observe.
Yes,
it's not. Don't mind people. Nobody will tell you.
Mm-hmm.
It's within you.
Yes.
The kingdom is within you. If you are following Jesus in true repentance, you will find that you can easily stay with him.
Yes.
He's not going to be boring.
At all.
He's not boring to me. I've been with him for 35 years plus. And he gets, I keep falling in love with Jesus over and over and over and over again. I keep falling in love with Jesus over and over and over and over again. He gets sweeter and sweeter as the days go by. Oh, what a love between my Lord and I keep falling in love with Jesus over and over and over and over again. I'm loving everything. So people are tired of Jesus. Give me your time. I'm looking for more time with Jesus. If you are tired of him, give me your time. Let me add to my time. He's worthy. He's faithful. Keep away from charlatans. If you notice any fake Christian, well, they are fake Christians. The Bible calls them false brethren. Disconnects. It's time for you to begin to joke with your life. Focus on the kingdom of God. We insist on God. Insist on holiness.
Yes, yes.
Insist on the truth.
Yes,
keep on renewing yourself. As you are waiting, God Almighty is putting new things in you.
Amen.
I wasn't like this before.
At all.
Even yesterday, I wasn't like this yesterday. I'm renewing every day.
Hallelujah.
It's a new day.
Amen.
It's a brand new day.
Hallelujah.
Don't follow anybody that's going to corrupt the word in you.
Amen.
No, there's a people that did you know that there's power in sleep?
Yes.
The first time I entered train, we're going to pray very soon. I entered train the first time. Not train of America. America, when I entered UK train, I thought I was already in heaven. Not that kind of train. Nigerian train is not an ordinary train. Because the rails are already, it goes off the rail. So I was afraid because my parents are already persecuting me. They say, conference you are going to, whether you will come back alive, we don't even know. So I needed to be alive. So I was in the train. I sat down in the train. I said, Ankechi, you will not sleep. You must know where these people are moving this train. I was looking, but my left to my right, they were senior snorers. They were sleeping. As they were sleeping, I didn't know when I wake up. Learn to wake up yourself.
Yes.
Because the Bible says, 1,000 shall fall by your side, 10,000 by your right. People are going to fall around you. There will be sleepers around you. There will be people that are going to fall out of the faith. People that used to preach holiness, they are going to change. People that used to dress holiness, they are going to change. God Almighty said, learn to wake up yourself in me. Because it's going to happen. The devil will do anything to draw you and I out from following Jesus. He will use anything in life. We are not going to sleep.
Amen.
We are of the day,
yes,
not of the night. We are going to be awake.
Amen.
People of God, we are going to pray the next 15 minutes. Yes. God Almighty is going to strengthen you and I. Say, I receive strength today.
Yes.
As I wait upon the Lord, I receive strength. I receive strength. Lift your voice and give God praise. Hey, Kalaba, lift your voice and give Him glory. I appreciate God for His word. Oh, somebody over there, give Him praise. Lift your voice and give God glory. The Bible says, they that wait upon the Lord, they shall renew. Your strength shall be renewed. Oh, Kalaba, can I hear somebody over there? Everybody, whoa, lift your voice and give God praise. I give Him glory. Thank you for your word, Lord. Your word is forever settled in heaven, oh God. In Jesus Christ's mighty name, we are praying. Father, have mercy on me. When I look down on my salvation, cry for mercy. Oh,
Continue to press on. The songwriter says, so I'm here today because God kept me. Edify yourselves because of that great day. The day of wrath is coming. Oh, you don't have to worry. And don't you be afraid. Joy comes in.
In a place where you are not there.
In spite of the rocks
and the rocks
and I crack
cracking of is part of earthquake,
is
part of the fire,
is
part of the wind.
Father,
open my eyes. Don't see that you are not there. And pull me out. Let me walk out. Let me run out. Pull me out. Lift your face and pray to God. Lift your face and pray to God. Father, monitor, monitor, monitor. Monitor me. Monitor my children. Monitor my family. You find us in the wrong place. There you are not. You are not here. We are going there. Father, what are the excitement? Lord, I look happy. How the medical doctor, whoever they are, deliver me for putting my trust in a human being. Have mercy on me. Open your mouth and cry to God. Have mercy on me, Lord. Deliver me today from the trust of me, from the fear of human being. What will human being say? We don't know the law that has been used on you, and you are under a bondage of the laws of power. They are 48 in number, and great men, your boss uses it in the office. Some of you, your husbands are using it. Some of you, even your wife is using it. But it is used by people that want to have influence. When they want to have influence over people, they use the 48 laws of power, sponsored by Lucifer, by the devil himself. We are going to pray, say, Father.
Anyone
who has used the 48 laws of power?
Who has used the 48 laws of power?
All my life.
All my life.
All my family.
All my family.
All your children.
All your children.
Father, destroy their power now. Don't blame us. Don't put us in bondage. Lord, deliver us. Open your mouth and pray. Don't be quiet, I beg you. Don't be quiet, I beg you. Rakalabakosundaya. In Jesus Christ, mighty name, we are praying. Amen. Let us say, Father. Anywhere I have added to your word.
Oh, I subtracted.
And as even attracting a curse on me already. Father, please have mercy on me, Lord. Restore me, Lord. Restore my family. Open your mouth and cry to God. Knowingly or unknowingly. You have begun to add. You are subtracting. Hey, love what I tell you. Forgive me, Lord. Have mercy on me,
Separated to thee, that I may be.
strength, giving us prosperity of the soul. God bless you for coming. The Lord will continue to uphold you. You will not be weary in well doing. You will not give up the race. You will not be tired of watching. You will not be tired of waiting. The Lord God Almighty will preserve your soul and your entire family. You will not join others. You are on the mountain top. God bless you. If Jesus tarries, we will see again on the Zoom tomorrow, and on a Friday we will see again for the soul meal and prayer. Keep on sharing the message and keep on calling people for us to join together to pray, for there is a rock to come. We are escaping that rat. That's why we are sober in the place of prayer. We are not joining others to be excited, because there is a rat on the way, and God said we are going to escape. He's going to remove us from that rat. You and I will not fall into that rat. We shall come out in the name of Jesus. God bless you. Shalom, shalom. Shalom, daddy. Shalom, mommy. Shalom, all my brothers and sisters. Be comforted. Be edified. Be encouraged. We are on the righteous side. God bless you. Love you plenty, plenty. It is well with your soul. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Lift your voice and say, Father.
Jesus, God, where will you be?